Good morning again, and welcome to our second session on the digital transformation enhancements in JD Edwards Release 25. In just a moment, Anne's going to show you the latest digital transformation enhancements in JDE, which include usability enhancements and AI-driven features to optimise workflows and boost operational efficiency. For those of you who missed the first session, we are keeping things deliberately short because we value your time and our own. So questions are very welcome and will be addressed at the end of the session, or you can submit questions using the questions tab on the GoToWebinar panel. And if you're not already familiar with our wonderful presenter, well, you are about to be, because I'm handing things over to Anne right now.
Thank you, Sasha. Okay, so what we're going to go through now is all basically the tools release enhancements in release 25. There are various topics that we'll be covering, and they, yeah, basically we've got the Enterprise Process Modeler, which we'll have a bit of a more detailed look at. Those of you that were in the applications session earlier would have noted that Oracle have delivered some process model templates, and this is how we manage those templates via this enterprise and create new models via the Enterprise Process Modeler. So we'll have a look at that. We'll look at some of the new outputs in Orchestrator. We'll take a look at some row and form exit enhancements, and we will then look at some enhancements to orchestration rules. And lastly, but not least, well, depending on how you look at it, is the addition of a couple of tiles on the E1 pages. So let's have a look at this Enterprise Process Modeler. So the Enterprise Process Modeler allows you to model your processes, and it creates loads of metrics and graphs, and so that you can actually monitor what's going on within your processes. What I'd like to do is go into JDE and give you a little bit of a flavor for what's going on there. So effectively, what you've got once the feature is enabled is under this manage processes, you've got manage content, you've got this processes option. And when you go into that processes option, it'll finally come back to me. It says to you, the first time you go in, it will ask you whether you want to create which template you want to use to create your process. So at the moment, there are two templates delivered that we saw in the apps session earlier. The first one is the procure to pay, and the other one is the order to cash. Well, let's take that procure to pay template as an example, and I'll click OK here. And you'll see that it says to me, what order type do you want your process to monitor, and what line type? And then what starting status? So basically what it's going to do is it's going to take the parameters that you set in here, and it's going to generate a process map or process model based on the order statuses according to the order activity rules. And you'll see that, okay, so we're going from enter purchase order to 20. And that goes to the approval status. It could also be 220 might go to the print purchase order, depending on the order type, and so on and so forth. So it builds this model here. You will then have options to change this as we like. The first thing we have to do, though, before we change it, is create it. So I'm going to create a model from this template. And I'm going to call it demo, because I'm very imaginative. Click OK. Now I've got this demo. You'll notice that it's just a UDO, like all the other UDOs that we've got. It will generate a UDO, and we manage it via UDOs as well. So it's just another kind of UDO at the end of the day. So now I've got this, if I go to this tab here, I've then got this. So we've created this model based on the procure to pay template. And now what I can do is I can show these filter options here and I can change them according to what I need. And you can change these on the run as well. But let me at the moment, you know, once we're operating them, I'm going to change the order date to that. I can also change things like the next status or the last status, and you've got the normal operators here and so on. Okay, so I'm going to just, all I'm doing at the moment is changing this order date, but you can set it up as you like. And because we now have orders based on those dates, it's brought the information in here. And what it's brought in is it's brought in order values and it's also got quantities and so on. Okay, and you can set these up to display quantities or display order value or whatever you like, or a combination. It's whatever you, however you need to set it up. Here are the ways that we design options and so on. I won't go through all of those today. Okay. But the nice thing about this process, once you've got it and you've changed it and you've moved things around and got it looking the way you want it to look and so on, is that you've got these nodes. And with these nodes, we've got various metrics that it's showing. So for those where the last status is, where the last status is 230, waiting for approval, we can see that here are the customers, and we can manage these metrics as well, if you like. We can expand them out and see them. You can see, so for the nodes, we can see all of those. We can see similar information for the links, in other words, the from and the to status. Okay, that one doesn't show very much. Let's go to this one, it's more interesting. Okay, so you've got various metrics being shown for the links, and you've also got metrics that are shown for the entire process. Yeah, in this case, it's not showing very much, I must say. What's gone on? It's gone to sleep. But there are metrics. Believe me, there are metrics along the for the entire process as well. Okay, so once you've got that and you've saved it, and you've set it up the way you want and you've saved it, when you come out of here, you close it, and you would go and publish it, and, you know, the same as you would any other you do and so on. Then what you've got in under personalization, you've got this enterprise processes here. Okay, and when you go into there, all the processes that you have access to are available to be displayed. So here's the demo one. There are some others that are, oh no, there aren't any others, but usually there might be a series of them that are here. And you can then work with them. You can change the order value. Oh, I did want to show you this. You can change whether it goes red or yellow or green or blue, at least, based on the numbers here, based on the metrics. So you have full control of your process. And of course, you have all these metrics that are being displayed on the right. So that's the Enterprise Process Modeler. I think it's pretty neat. At the moment, there are two templates. There's the order to cash and there's the procure to pay template. I expect more templates to come in the future, but at the moment, those are the two that we've got. Okay. So the other thing that's been introduced in the tools is as return values in the orchestration outputs. So when you go to the end and outputs and your orchestration, you will now see under outputs, you will see system values. And these are all the system values that are now available to the output with your orchestration. You can see there's user address book, user ID, system date, orchestration inputs, the environment, and so on. The orchestration ID. Okay, so these are now all available as outputs from your orchestration. Another option, another feature that's been delivered in Orchestrator is, well, it's actually in form extensions, but it's the ability to call an orchestration from a row or form exit. This one I absolutely love. So we've already had the ability to create or to add row or form exits to our forms and applications. Now we've got the ability to associate an orchestration with them. You can associate an orchestration using this little button here. As you can see, you can do it on a new row or form exit that you've added, like I have, or on existing ones. So you can have an orchestration that is associated with an existing row or form exit. And once you click the little pencil there, it takes you through to the normal screens that we all know and love to associate orchestrations, notifications, logic extensions, whatever it is, with this, the same as you would associate with a button up until now. Now you can associate with a row exit or a form exit as well. Here I've created a logic extension, which asks me to input a new industry code, and I've associated that logic extension with a row exit called update industry code. I would then tick all the, I've set this up on the address book, and I would then tick all the addresses that I wanted to update the industry code on. When I click the row exit, it will pop up with my, for me to enter the industry code, and then it would run it. Yep, so that's adding an orchestration to calling an orchestration or a logic extension or a notification from a row or form exit. I think this has got many applications, this particular enhancement. Okay, then another thing that we've got that they've enhanced is the orchestration rules and what we can do there. I'll just take you in again into JDE and we can have a quick look. If I go and look at, well, and let's go into the orchestrator. It's probably a good place to start. See, it's logged me out. That's because I haven't been in there for a short while, as you know. I'm using, you'll notice my sign on there. It was customer. I'm using the Oracle sandbox to show these. This stuff. Okay, it's available to anybody who wants to use it, the Oracle sandbox. If you need to know anything more about it, let me know. I'll tell you about how to access the Oracle sandbox. Okay, so basically, there have been some enhancements in the rules area where if you click, say you say order type is in list, and if you click on the list, you've now got the ability, you can still specify the variables one by one for a list, or you can use an array. So you can actually put in an array name here and a column within that array so that you can then have a rule that works off a variable number. Oh, I know I've done this many times. I'm going to unclick that first before I can close it. So you can have a variable number of items within the list that you want to pass through to a rule. Okay, so that's one thing that has been enhanced. And then the other one, the last one, is this text and images on the EnterpriseOne pages. So again, within JD Edwards, if I go to, let me click on home first of all, and I go to our standard manage contents composed pages. And if I add a designer pane, wants me to drag and drop, let me add, that's because there is already one here. It's a bit slow coming up. Oh, there we go, here it is. Okay. So on a designer page, let's say my next one, I just want to have some text. I've got two new tile types here. They don't go anywhere. They don't do anything. They are simply text and image. And if I enter the text, I can then go and enter text here. whatever text I see fit to enter. Perhaps I'm going to say at this stage, because I'm doing a process flow, perhaps go and get a cup of coffee while we wait for a manager to approve the POs. And that would then come up as a tile, just the text. And similarly, you can add an image as a separate tile. They don't do anything. They simply come up as text or image over here. Okay. All right. So that's the new tiles in the Enterprise One pages. And that is also all the enhancements for release 25 that I want to show you. As usual, I can't emphasize enough the value of going to learnjde.com. Learnjde.com is your go-to page for anything JD Edwards. Oracle do a fantastic job there, so please go and have a look at it. And any questions, happy to answer. Send me an email, phone me, whatever you like. Drop me a message in Teams, whatever you like. Sasha, over to you.
Thanks, Anne. So just while we wait for any questions to come through, I'm just going to take a moment to remind everybody how amazing our team are. Our very experienced and skilled JDE consultants deliver awesome support, training, and innovative JD Edwards-based solutions, including things like AP automation and even mobile applications for JDE. We provide all the services you could need for your JDE system and end users, including implementations and upgrades, training support and managed services and cloud migrations, plus development and CNC services. And just another reminder that if you do need skilled resources or support over the holiday period, you can email info@ndevr.com.au, tom.devine@ndevr.com.au, or andrew.janke@ndevr.com.au. And questions I have got. And what are the steps involved in preparing for an upgrade?
Oh, sure. Okay. Step one. Phone Ndevr.
Yeah. Okay.
Honestly, it depends on your environment, of course. So yeah, it depends on where you are in your journey, what release you're on at the moment. But basically, we can help you with that. We can help you with upgrading to the latest release. Yeah. Seriously, give us a call.
All right. We'll get in touch with that individual a bit later. I have one other question here. It says, are there other process model templates available?
No, not at the moment. The process model templates, there are only the two, order to cash and procure to pay, but I do expect that there will be more coming. I imagine as we've got a lot of enterprise automation E1 pages, I expect that there will also be more templates coming, process model templates, but not at the moment, just the two at the moment.
I have one other, it's a comment, not a question. It just says, nice presentation, Anne, thank you.
Oh, thanks very much.
And if that is everything, I'll just sign us off here. I want to thank Anne for taking the time to prepare and deliver our presentations today. And a big thank you to all of you for tuning in as well. And have a Merry Christmas, a safe new year, and we look forward to working with you again in 2025.
Thanks, everybody. Bye-bye.
Thank you.